very warm welcome. You're watching the news with me, Anubhuti Gaur. Let's take a look at what's making headlines. 5 months after the government ended special status under Article 370 and bifurcated it into two union territories, union ministers will begin their special visit to J&K from today. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has asked ministers to spread the message of development in Jammu and Kashmir with a focus on rural areas. Those tasked with the outreach include ministers Piyush Goyal, Jitendra Singh, Ravi Shankar Prasad, Kiran Rijiju, Hardeep Puri, G. Kishan Reddy and others. Pakistan reacts to the statements of Indian Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat, where he suggested de-radicalisation camps for the radicalised youth in the Kashmir Valley and a concerted effort to tackle terrorism globally. Condemning the statement, Pakistan said that these remarks are reflective of the extremist mindset and bankrupt thinking that have evidently also permeated the state's institutions of India. Speaking at the Raisina Dialogue 2020 in New Delhi, Rawat, in a clear reference to Pakistan, sought diplomatic isolation and blacklisting by the anti-terror watchdog FATF of the country's sponsoring terrorism. Senior advocate Indra Jaisingh urged Nirbhaya's mother to pardon the men on death row who were convicted for the 2012 gang rape of her daughter. Indra Jaisingh took to Twitter to make the request shortly after Asha Devi on Friday expressed her disappointment when a Delhi court postponed the date of execution of the four convicts to February 1st from the previous date of January 22nd. She wrote, and I quote, While I fully identified with the pain of Asha Devi, I urge her to follow the example of Sonia Gandhi, who forgave Nalini and said she didn't want the death penalty for her. We are with you, but against the death penalty. After the Patiala House Court issued a fresh death warrant in the Nirbhaya gang rape and murder case, one of the convicts in the case, Pawan Kumar Gupta, has moved the Supreme Court against a Delhi High Court order dismissing his plea that he was a juvenile at the time of the incident in December 2012. The Delhi High Court in December declined to entertain his plea, claiming he was a juvenile. The trial court had already rejected his plea. Reacting to the controversy triggered by Shiv Sena MP Sanjay Raut's remark that former Prime Minister Indira Gandhi used to meet Don Karim Lala, Nationalist Congress Party Chief Sharad Pawar on Friday said that he shouldn't have made the comment, but since Raut has withdrawn the statement, hence I don't want to push the issue. Remember, Raut's comment had left the Congress Party fuming. Historian Ramchandra Guha made a sharp attack on Rahul Gandhi, saying that the fifth generation dynast, Rahul Gandhi has no chance in the Indian politics against the hard-working and self-made Narendra Modi. And Kerala did a disastrous thing by electing the Congress leader to the parliament. He went on to say that the reduction of Congress Party from a great party during the freedom movement to a pathetic family firm now is one of the reasons for Hindutva and jingoism in India. That's all in this bulletin. Thanks for watching. The news and updates will continue on the other side.